Hello there, again. My name is Sean Crawford, and I'm going to be making one of these staples of food, kielbasa and sauerkraut. Basically, what I did was I took whole kielbasa, and I just boiled it in water a little bit, just, you know, cook it. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring it over here and put it on this grill, so I can get a nice, like, grill mark on it. I'll let that sit there for a bit. While that is working up a nice char, we will open up this package of sauerkraut and put that in this pan, which will be the bed for the kielbasa. That's all out in there. We'll just spread this around a little bit. Okay. Let's see how this kielbasa is doing. One more time. Kielbasa and me have a very, very long history with each other. Kielbasa is actually the reason why I got into the culinary arts field. Because when I was 12, my dad would make kielbasa and sauerkraut every Wednesday night. And eventually I just said, you know what, Dad, I hate kielbasa. I'm never eating it again. So he said, okay, make your own meals. So I just started cooking, and then that evolved into this. So let's see now. That's a math a little bit. But kielbasa is pretty amazing food. I think there's around six main types, but the only thing that we've changed between them is just, I think it's fat content and thickness. So this is a Polish kielbasa, so this is around like a mid-range thickness, and it's like the beginner kielbasa. One of the other great things about kielbasa is that there's a ton of ways to cook it. Like, as I said earlier, you can boil it, you can grill it, you can, you know, sear it in a pan, slice it in half, and then, you know, just bake it. You can do it, really anything to it. You can serve it on a bun, which is pretty popular. I have salt, pepper, and brown sugar. Now, the brown sugar is not going on until after. Right now, I'm just going to put a little salt, pepper on this. Something my dad taught me how to do. But basically, it's really just a waiting game of waiting for the kielbasa to get brown and then just putting it into the sauerkraut. One of the good things about kielbasa and sauerkraut is that the sauerkraut is like very like tart, crisp taste, and the kielbasa is sort of almost like a sweet, meaty taste, so they kind of like play off of each other. And, you know, I used to hate it when I was younger, but now I love it now, so it's like, I don't know, it's different. Originally, I was just going to do chocolate chip cookies with this, but then I was like, eh, I'll do something that I actually like. What I'm doing right now is just trying to position it across the grill so that way I get diagonal grill marks on it. Just for looks, pretty much. Now, I know earlier I mentioned that I had brown sugar. Normally, brown sugar would not usually go with classy and sauerkraut, but I actually inherited that trait from my dad of adding brown sugar to anything, so I literally put it in everything. I put it in salad before. It's not that bad, but classy and sauerkraut, I like it. Okay. Now we'll just place the kielbasa glue. Place the kielbasa on the bed of sauerkraut. Sprinkle on some salt and pepper. Then we'll put on some brown sugar. Okay, and now we just we can put it in this. And we just pop it in the oven for like 5 or 10 minutes, and then we get to. And that's pretty much all.